Tesla just made a rare and important update on semi trucks weight. Tesla says Tesla's semi electric trucks weight is on point, and that's crucial. In this report, I'm going to explain what this means. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla and electric vehicle impartial news, and give us thumbs up, please, if you find this report helpful. Electrek notes that Tesla made a rare comment about the Tesla semi-electric truck's weight, which is going to be crucial to the success of the electric truck. The automaker says that Tesla semi will be able to transport a payload, quote, at a list as high as it would be for a diesel truck, end of the quote. That's rare and important. In the United States, Class 8 trucks are required to weigh less than 80,000 pounds with their load. Electrek notes, saying, since the load is what makes trucking money, the weight of the actual truck is extremely important, since every pound in tractor weight is a pound that is not being transported for a paying customer. There have been some concerns that battery electric trucks would be heavier and therefore they would be at a disadvantage having to carry lighter loads. Although I spoke with a friend who is a truck driver, he is looking forward for Tesla semi and says, I will buy one when it comes into production. Now, Tesla CEO Elon Musk previously said that Tesla semi would have this issue, as he expects that in the worst case scenario, the Tesla semi would have to give up less than 1 ton to diesel trucks, which weigh about 17,000 pounds, 8.5 tons on average. In a rare new comment about the situation as part of its 2020 impact report, Tesla said that it now expects the Tesla semi to be able to carry a payload, quote, at least as high as it would be for diesel truck, at least, end of the quote. Electrek notes that the credit goes to them. Interestingly, the company reports a little known fact that electric trucks in the US and Europe have both been approved for slightly higher total loads, with both the United States and EU having approved higher weight allowances for electric heavy-duty trucks. We expect the payload to be at least as high as it would be for a diesel truck. In European Union, electric semi trucks are allowed to be 2 tons, approximately 4,400 pounds, heavier than diesel equivalent. And in the United States, the allowance is 0.9 tons, 2,000 pounds. When fully loaded, the Tesla semi should be able to achieve over 500 miles of range achieved through aerodynamics and highly efficient motors. This truck will be able to reach an efficiency of over 0.5 miles per kilowatt hour. While a 2,000 pound difference doesn't sound like much leeway on an 80,000 pound limit, it's going to give Tesla semi just enough to compete with diesel trucks, notes Electrek. Electrek also says that if Tesla says that they expect to have a payload at least as high as it would be for a diesel truck, it would mean that Tesla semi currently weighs less than 2,000 pounds more than the average diesel truck. Okay, less than 2,000 pounds more than the average diesel trucks. Furthermore, actual real-world data shows that 90% of semi trucks weigh in at less than 73,000 pounds with their loads. Therefore, Tesla semi should have no problem competing for the majority of these payloads. Also, friends, Tesla made a rare new comment on Tesla semi's efficiency in the impact report. Again, the credit goes to Electrek. They noted this. The automaker now claims an efficiency of over 0.5 miles per kilowatt hour, which is in line with the less than 2 kilowatt hour per mile efficiency announced at the original launch of the electric semi-truck. Depending on electricity rates, this has the potential to greatly reduce the cost of operation of trucks while slashing emissions from the very polluting trucking sector, not Electrek. While the automaker has made progress toward bringing the truck to low volume production in Nevada, Tesla recently confirmed that the customer deliveries of the Tesla Semi are pushed to next year. This is not a big deal because next year is around the corner and we didn't expect much Tesla Semi delivers this year anywhere. Just several trucks, maybe 10, 15 or 20 or 30, I don't know, maximum, but the majority of the trucks deliveries were going to be next year anyway. In another news, we are learning how beneficial Tesla Giga Berlin's opening will be for Giga Shanghai and Tesla in general. Tesla Giga Berlin will be the electric car maker's kind of a reliever, savior in a logistical nightmare that requires the company to ship cars from China to Europe, Weightbash analyst Dan Ive said in a note this morning. By the way, I spoke about that in my previous video. If you haven't seen, please look at that in details. I'm talking about the Giga Berlin's opening, the date, and so on. Now, Joey Klender from Tesla Radio notes that yesterday Tesla CEO Elon Musk stated that he expects Giga Berlin, the company's first European production facility, to start assembling cars in just 2 months. We're hoping to get the final approval in October or Oktoberfest. An Oktoberfest approval, Musk said, the sooner Tesla can get the Berlin factory up and running, the sooner it can free itself of the import of vehicles to Europe from Shanghai, a process that is, quote, not sustainable, according to Weightbash analyst Dan Ives, a Tesla bull who has a buy rating on the company's stock with a price target of $1,000. Like I have said previously, I'm not a stockholder. Please don't take this as a stock advice. I'm just providing information. I don't hold any stocks and I'm not in the stock market. Now, the inclusion of the Berlin Gigafactory into Tesla's production spreadsheet increases the company's annual assembly rate, which the company continues to do what seems like a quarterly basis. According to MarketWatch, Ives wrote in the note to investors that the opening of the factory is a positive step on expanding Tesla's broader manufacturing capacity globally. However, in Ives' analysis, the more crucial portion is that Tesla will no longer have to import cars, electric cars, from China to all the way to Europe, a move that the company intended to on never taking anyway. Tesla sent China-made Model 3 units to Europe in January for the first time. The strategy has increased the company's presence in the electric vehicle savvy region of Europe, but has also decreased deliveries in China, where the sector is growing. Tesla is no way has a negative track record in China and has sold its vehicles extremely well there. However, the absence of a European assembly facility has forced the company to split its Chinese production lines between domestic and foreign regions, which Elon Musk detailed in a tweet yesterday. Well, friends, let me know your thoughts on all these developments. This is Armin Haryan from torquenews.com. Have a great day and I'll see you soon in our next report. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla and electric news, impartial news, and give us thumbs up for this report, please, if you find it informative. God bless you, everyone. Peace be with all of you. And I'll see you soon in our next report.